Weaponeer here, and I thought I'd introduce you to some LaRue tactical products. The first one is the little index clip. It's not very big, but it serves a big purpose. Now, if anybody has ever had a optic on your rifle and you went ahead and you removed the optic, when you put it back, were you always wondering if you were putting it back in the same exact spot? Now, if there's wear marks on your, you know, on your rails or something like that, you might come really darn close enough that it doesn't really matter. But with some of these mounts these days, you know, especially the QD mounts, where you can just slide it right on and lock it. Now, especially like the LaRue mounts that I use. Now, if you're using something like that, putting it back in the same exact spot is very important. And that's where these little index clips came in. These allow you to clip right on top of your, you know, rail if you're working with an optic. You take this, you clip it right in front of your optic, right in front of the mount. And once you have it clipped in place, then you're able to remove your optics, use your iron sights, and then replace your optic, and it's going to be back replaced back in the same exact spot. So once you mount it back in the same spot, you're going to have a better chance of getting a return to zero, no matter what kind of scope or mount it is. So these little clips right here are actually quite important. Now, like I said, you get 72 of these, and with the, you know, you get the 60 regular ones, which is this one right here, and then you get 4 of the lower hooks, and then you get 8 of the top keepers, and they're all pretty much alike. They all look primarily the same, unless you take a really good close look at them. And you know, this right here is a regular one, and this one right here is the upper hook, and and this one right here is the lower hook. So, you know, they all look the same at this distance. But what makes them unique is they allow you to control your wiring. Now, if you're having wires coming back from the front of the rifle on back, let's say they're from, you know, pressure pads for lasers or for flashlights or any kind of optics, you're able to control the wiring, any kind of cabling you have, with these little extra clips. Now, you don't get a whole lot of them. Like I said, you get the, you know, you get 8 of the top keepers and 4 of the lower clips, allowing you to mount it on the lower side. And this allows you to ensure that your wiring is out of the way. It's not going to snag on anything. You know, if you snag something, you might disable your pressure system. You know, so if you go ahead and, you know, you put pressure on it, you might not be able to get it to function. So something like this, it's going to make sure that your pressure switches, your cables are all going to go ahead and stay in perfect operating shape and perform the most optimal job of making sure you're going to return your optics to the same position every single time. But they do something else. Now, I am not one to really like a lot of the rail covers. Most of the ones I've used, I just haven't liked for one reason or another, either too hard to install or, you know, too hard to remove. If I have to remove one to put something on the rifle in a hurry. The AR or M16 series, they're modular weapon, and they're designed to be modular for a reason, so you can go ahead and, you know, place parts on it, remove parts on it very quickly. And if you have a rail on there, it's a pain in the rear to remove. It's no good to me. Now, in this case, I have AR-57. This is a rifle that I used in the last video, and this is it's a cross between a P90 and an AR. Now, what I mean by a cross between a P90 and AR, it uses obviously it's a 5.7 millimeter rather than a 5.56, and it uses P90 magazines, 50 round mags. So you have a perfect CQB or, you know, personal defense weapon. Nice small package. Adjustable, no problem at all. Now, the only thing is for me, I'll make sure that I mark where the optics are. I put one of these clips in here, and I don't have to worry about it anymore. Once that clip is in place, I can remove the optics and replace it. Like this one right here, I'm going to be replacing the optics for something a little bit higher end, but until then, I'm going to make sure that this index clip is always in the same spot, so if I ever have to remove it for maintenance, cleaning, wherever else, I can make sure it's replaced in the same spot so I don't lose my zero. Now the other thing is you have this little hook right here, and that's called a hand stop. The hand stop is a very important little piece. It may not look like much, but you get two of these. If you order the hand stop, it comes in a two-piece set. This is what it looks like off the rail. This right here fits a mill standard M1913 Picatinny rail, and this is a very good quality piece. I don't see any flashing. I don't see any seams. Nothing. I mean, everything is perfectly, it's just a really good quality piece. Like I said, you get two of these. This is a glass reinforced polymer. It's got a nice ergonomic profile to it, and all you do is you slide it right on the rail. Now, here's the interesting part here. You cannot buy just this. If you're interested in the hand stop, you can't buy just the hand stop and get it to work. The reason is, unless you have some other form of locking this in place, this does not lock by itself. It just slides on the rail, and which is really simple. All you have to do is just take it to your rail and then just slide it right on. And once you slide it right onto this position where you want it, then you would normally take an index clip. And you take an index clip and you snap it on the front and you snap it on the bottom, snap it above and below it, and it locks it in place. So it's not going to be removed. And here's the whole deal. If you're trying to retain the best possible accuracy, you want to make sure that everything is always consistent, whether it be a consistent hold, consistent trigger, pull, everything has to be consistent. And the hand stop allows you to have a nice consistent hold. I do like this. It's one of the only times I've ever used this style. I typically will use the magazine housing grip or a standard grip, but this is the first time I've ever used this one. And on this rifle, it performed flawlessly. Didn't have any problems with it at all. I didn't have any problems getting used to it. It was just a natural piece. I put it on, it doesn't get snagged on anything. If I'm going through brush is deflected right off, which is even better because it actually gets deflected around my hand rather than get snagged on it. If you're going through thorns and stuff like that, it's a really cool thing. Now, you can also use the index clips as rail covers right here, and I just snap some in place. Like I said, you get 60 of these things, and you snap them in place, you can cover up your whole rail, or rail like this, without any problem. The cool thing is, if you go ahead and get two different colors, this comes in a number of different colors. For this one right here, it comes in like your brown, your green, black. I think in these, in the index clips, I think you even get these in red. These comes in a number of different colors. Now, if you wanted to get like a tan and either an OD or something, you could mix the two colors and you could do your own camouflage right in the rail without having to paint the rail, which is a really nice thing because once you go ahead and you paint a rail, Duracoat's a little bit different, but if you're going to paint a rail, what happens is a lot of that paint starts wearing off, and once it wears off, it looks like crap. So yeah, you put a lot of money into these and you don't want it to be looking like hell. So something like using these right here, this really is a neat job where you can actually take these and put a nice digital style pattern on here. It's really simple. Just place a couple of your brown, a couple of your green, and just keep it up with the pattern all the way around, and you're going to break up the pattern on the outline of the rifle, which is what you're trying to do with camouflage to begin with. Now, this right here allowed me to have a nice consistent grip, and it was the first thing that was noticed on the video. Someone said, I really like that, I'd like to have one, what is it, where can I buy it? Well, this right here, like I stated before, this right here is the LaRue Tactical Hand Stop. I'll have the link below. And it comes in a two-piece set. It's a two-piece set. It's about $25. You might be able to do better on that. And these index clips here for the 72 clip cam, that's about $29.95 for the retail. I'm just giving you retail prices. And, you know, to be able to do your entire rail for $30, that's not really bad, considering the prices of some of these rail covers lately. You can't go ahead and mix colors, not yet at least. It would be nice if you can go ahead and get, you know, 15 of one color and 15 of another color. That would really help mix it up a little bit. How did it perform in out the range? I didn't have any problems whatsoever. Matter of fact, I actually really liked it. It actually allowed me to have a nice consistent grip. It was hot, we were sweaty, and this allowed me to have a nice grip without losing my grip and without grabbing a hold of the actual rail itself. The rails, you know, you can cut up your hands and stuff like that with them, so I'd rather have something covering them or wearing gloves. But with these rail covers, I didn't have to do that. Fit really good. The ergonomics of the hand stop worked very, very nicely. I was really surprised. It really works really nice. But the only thing is you in order to use the hand stop, you have to have indexing clips or a way of locking it on to the top and the bottom. Otherwise, it's just going to slide off. So just remember that, you know, when you buy index clips themselves, you do not get the hand stop. Hand stop and clips are sold separately. Now, let's see. The index clips comes in 6 different colors. So, like I said, you have a large amount of colors to choose from, or to, if you want to use it on several different rifles, you can buy one kit per rifle and then mix the colors and you can have your own camouflage pattern, which is probably what I would suggest. So there you go, these are the AR-57 with the LaRue index clips, as well as the LaRue hand stop. I do highly recommend these. It does work as you would think from any kind of LaRue product. And I've been a LaRue product user for many years, and you know, I don't have any problem at all purchasing from them. I know when I purchase something from them, it's going to be a quality piece. And in this case, once again, they made sure that they kept up their reputation. It is a quality piece, something I highly recommend. And if you have any comments about it, I want you to go ahead and post it below. So once again, any comments, post it below. Don't forget to subscribe to my videos. Don't forget to rate my videos. I'm Weaponeer, and I'll catch you in the next one. Come on.